What's up, everyone? Welcome to Union Gaming. This is your host, Roz, and welcome to episode 4 of my West of Loathing playthrough for the Switch. Last video, we did a bunch of wandering around Dirtwood and stuff, and then we got a new hat, and we found a circus hidden in the middle of everything, so we're there right now. You approach the clown, puts on a basic, cheerful facial expression that his retail employees use, and the last thing they want to deal with is a customer, but you're not allowed to say so. Let's talk to him. Welcome to Barnaby Bob's perfectly normal traveling circus sideshow, sir. How may I help you? I'd like to see the circus, please. You came to the right place, then. If you want to go inside, you'll need a ticket. Presumably you can sell me one? Why, certainly I can. It's my job, after all. For you, sir, a ticket will be 5,000 meat. Say what? Does that seem a bit high? I promise you, sir, that's the price of a real steal. Well, you got that right. Why is it so expensive? Well, it is not no podunk traveling circus. We got rides, games, food, an amazing demonstration of knife throwing skill by none other than Barnaby Barb himself. Tell me more about Barnaby Barb, Bob. Oh, the boss is a real master of knives, let me tell you. He does this amazing stunt where he gets a volunteer for the audience up on the stage and throws knives at him. He never misses his target. Did you leave out the part where he puts an apple on their head or something? Oh, right, sure. Tell me more about the rides. Well, I suppose you could say ride, but we haven't had a single grizzly merry-go-round accident once since, well, we stopped turning it on. Tell me more about the games. Oh, we got tons of them. Does three count as tons? Three is more like some. Well, we got some of them. Alright, let's tell me about the food. We got people's favorite, popcorn sarsaparilla with the fancy new bottle caps, and get this, do you hear about the new thing a fella invented, cotton candy? Yeah, I think I might have. Well, it's still patented, but we'll figure out how to do it, but figure out how it works mostly, more or less. You're not doing a very good job of selling me on this. Whatever do you mean? Intimidate the clown. I mean, I'm sick of playing for a fool. You think I'm gonna shell out that much meat to get a dive like this? You got another thing coming. Are you gonna give me a ticket or am I gonna punch your ticket? Well, the yellow teeth usually pointed. I think you're a real tough cookie, huh? Listen up, good buckaroo. All I have to do is shout and you're a new sideshow. We'll call it the Amazing Crying Bag of Mulch. Hey, I get it. I'll get you in for free. How's that plan grab you? Why, I ought to step back, Junior. You're out of your depth. Okay. Hey, you need a ticket if you want in, Chief. Northern Clown Ward. Alright. Let's go, Yoshi. We need 5,000. Alright, okay. Now we gotta look up the Pottenham Gang. I think I'll execute this gang, since the last gang was like, all alive and stuff. This gang gets executed. Alright, let's see what this one here. Potemkin gang. Each one of them will need one of them will need to move to take advantage of the stuff behind the buildings. Okay. If you look near the bar. Doing wrong here. I don't So what's over here first? Town Hall. Gonna be in front of the town hall. Okay, so we'll move him over. Dang it. What was that dude on the ground? I don't get what I'm doing here. What are we doing here? Access to one of the gang members. Moved another building, used the outhouse, went behind, used the TNT, exploded the gang. I forced all the gang members to the jail and then cut the rope. Okay, so we gotta figure out how to get them all to the... jail. He's gonna have to go on his own. He's gonna have to wait. Thank you. hostler over. Dude, fucking move. Close enough here. Dang it. So I can scare her over there. Okay, so maybe that one dude isn't part of the gang. Go, dude. TNT. Okay, I don't know what I'm doing wrong here. Fuck it, I don't know. Alright, let's just fucking move on to the places we can do. Abandoned pickle factory. Head there next. Property of Fort All Dead Library. Dig through the bags. Cow Punch in volume 25. The Haunted Pickle Factory. Touch the doorknob. Ouch. Too late for your shift. Miss Blast is gonna be so mad she literally bite your head off. Well, not literally, literally, probably. You clock in a hurry up overall. Late again, you better stop talking to John for granted. You think you're gonna find a place such a nice dormitory with a reasonable price company like the store of ours? Your skills, how you're doing three shifts today, Buster. Get to work, you'll be a pickle hopper duty. Start your shift. If you get uneven pickle levels, Miss Blast knows nobody knows how she knows. Get a whack from arcade and the minimum you'll get. Damn it, damn it, damn it. Your first 6-hour shift, you get a first break. Ram a stale cheese sandwich in your mouth while Miss Blast glares at her pocket, counting the 3 minutes to the second. Break's over, second shift. Get over there into your salt tank now. Oh, God. Managing the salt tank isn't as strenuous as the pickle hoppers, but it's still a never-ending tension. The brine concentration has to be constantly monitored and kept at a specific minimum, which means constant adjustments. Meanwhile, if you feel yourself desiccating from the haze of saltness that fills the room. If anything in this place kills you, it's probably be salt tank duty. White lung is a nasty business. Cough on your own time and get that salinity back to normal. It's supposed to be 976 parts per thousand. How hard is that to remember? 976, idiot. Please let me out of here. You get another 180-second break before third shift. You spend most of it drinking water. The company doesn't charge for water, but you heard a rumor they're considering it. Break's over. Get to the boiler. Oh, God. Please let me out of this. Boiler duty is shoving coal into the furnace. A furnace that runs a jet boiling vinegar. It stings in here. You've tried to work with your eyes closed, but it screams if you drop any coal on the floor or if you let the temperature go too low or too high for no reason at all. At least you're used to smelling boiling vinegar. In fact, you can't smell anything else anymore. Please let me out of here. 190 degrees, idiot. Not 189, not 191. What do you think we'll pay you for? Let me out. Let me out. Let me out. The gas should probably snap out of the horrible losing or possession, whatever. So feel a stick of vinegar. Right. Let's enter the pickle factory. Says, pull it. Rats! It's okay, I took care of it. Paw bones and cucumbers. Rest in peace, my man. Alright, we took care of the cucumbers here. Salt. $190 for the vinegar. too. Pickle ghost. He slapped me with a ghostly pickle. Start blasting through this shit. Oh, these pickles got a lot of fucking health. Shit kicked out of us right now. Let's get beefy! Are missing. That's another dead pickle. Dead pickles. God, Curse Finn. He didn't even have legs. Rest in peace, poor guy. God, this is cool. Do that again. And then turn the... 7. Degrees. Turn valve once. 193. 8. 93 degrees. Turn valve. 83 degrees. 16 degrees. Release valve. 190, we got it. Pull it. I got ghost pickles. No wonder this place went out of business. Good pickles. big ol' heck is him. Dutch oven mine. This loose isn't very tight. Well, this is some stinky fish. Can't get any closer without some stench resistance at least. Learn. Learn the old 1, 2, 3. Sweet smell of flowers. That's barely tolerable. There's definitely west of the mountains, good to know. Looks like everything you got so far. That 5 minutes ago. Grab what's left. Oh, might as well. Shooting, there must be a crow's hole eating through the bottom. That hole gets in my plug hole or something unexpected. Spittoon is steady. You probably see stick lines coming off of it. It's fine. Inspect the spittoon. Hot cheese. Crouch down. It's filthy. You realize you're holding your breath, not deliberately, but for your body. Inhale. And someone, there's a big pot of chili con carne and left it under the fort. Three rats crawl in the pot, eat half the chili, and then die. A week later, family conquered. Nice. That's what it smells like. Fortunately, you eat the rainbow colored film on the surface of this liquid coat. Dissolve the bones. The smell intensifies the substance that hose off poisons off your left. High pressure stream of fog. Keep searching. Finger sets at the bottom. Better pull it out fast when you start to pull it out with. You pull out the most disgusting pair of pants with the spittoon. Now I'm clogged with leaking. Congratulations, I'm probably the worst object ever I've ever been paid to think about. Narrowly defeating a leather bondage harness made out of the skin of a clown. Wow. Worst object I have ever been paid to think about. Narrowly defeating a leather bondage harness made out of the skin of a clown. Hooray! I wonder what those pants are. I'm gonna equip the spit soaked pants. There was spiked pants. Lubricate it, and then ride it. That came out dirtier than I meant it to. Emerge the elevator deep shaft. By the light of your lantern, you see exposed meat veins on nearly every surface. It's unusual that there'd be this much available meat left working mine. What are you digging for? I'm just curious. That's totally out of it. He's gibbering and drooling, you know. Glimmer, 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 glub. Uh-huh. Maybe I'm trying to say such a rack at all. Well, let's get out of here real quick. I want to... They're going to dig deeper with their hands, okay? Come on down here. Not opposite end, we're dying here in the back. Good fingers in the bottom. Good. Boys begin screaming, try. You have to get out of the way. Mine, mine. Was down here. And pour together. Move the rocks by hand, pickaxe. Knock the rocks into leaving. Yeehaw! You're one smooth talker. Yes, I am.